the brake line kit that I ordered for the car is 1 3/8 inch too short. Here's the old brake line. This ingenious measuring method, take a string, put it on the end, roll it around, and you get your mark. Try as I might, I couldn't make this fit. It just didn't look right. And it was going to ride up too close to the shock or the spring, and I didn't want that. So a quick trip to your local AutoZone can sometimes be a good thing. They will rent you the brake flare kit for free, so you don't have to buy one. You just check it out, like at the library. The piece of tubing already comes pre-flared. It comes with fittings. They're the wrong kind, but we have these fittings off of the original. You don't need a brake tube cutting kit when you got a Dremel. Sandpaper to deburr. Get started. Put the fittings on. The correct direction. Here we go. Try to bend it into place. So I try to match up the angles. As close as I can. Pretty flexible. Just don't bend it too fast or too much, and you won't crimp it. again.
We're pretty close.
If you gotta go tight, I found this to be the best method. So you don't put a kink in it. Treatment. All right, let's see what happened. Hit the wrong button again. So we got it pretty tight. We're pretty much on. Got a little bend to go here. I think we're started. We're not started. Need a little bit more space over this way. Double check everything before you start filling it full of fluid. These are 17s and 11s. I don't know what the torque specs are on that, but I'm going to say pretty tight. Don't crush it tight, but pretty tight. And this is part of the steel brady kit. I put a little blue Loctite on there. Only because it's going to get some vibrations from bouncing back and forth. It's aluminum here, so don't over torque it. Then this will attach to the hard line on the car. I got one more brake line to start building, and then we can reassemble this thing and get it back in the car.